execution. The United States federal government should stop all executions in the state of Arkansas. We're going to base this debate on policy of net benefits. We're going to go over our background here. Right now, the governor of Arkansas is actually pushing for executions due to almost expired drugs. The drugs that right now, lethal injection, is those drugs right there are expiring for the inmates in Arkansas. So the Arkansas governor is saying, hey, we want to put these guys on death row on execution. So the drugs in the past have, thing is the drugs in the past have failed. They're not working effectively. Sometimes when they do get lethal injections, not all 100% of the time, they don't die. Harm for that is that death row inmates drain taxpayer dollars. These lethal injections cost taxpayers lots of dollars every single year in Arkansas. Our plan actually is to move death row inmates back to general population. Time frame and funding and enforcement is by normal means. Our solvency for that is that death row inmates will not be subdued to dehumanizing conditions due to expired drugs. If the plan doesn't pass, expired drugs will be used and prisoners will die painfully, such as painful. Other ways of painful execution is electric chair or being hung, which we consider both dehumanizing as compared to lethal injection, which is what we want them to keep around. There are advantage, going through our advantage one. Racial tensions are higher right now. Predominantly, Latinos and African Americans in prison are increasing in violence within the prison system. The link to that is that our plan stops the executions. So our internal link to that is the system disproportionately targets African Americans and minorities, which will be stopped if the executions were to stop also. So our impact for our plan is going to be that it's going to lower the decrease in number of deaths, beatings, and rapes, and also the violence is going to decrease in the prison system. Now, I just want to talk a little bit more about what the harm of the lethal injection actually is. It's very harmful. A lot of times when they actually do survive a lethal injection, they come away with many other problems as well. They come away with, sometimes they aren't the same person mentally after that. They have some type of disabilities after. So, because this medicine, this injection they're putting in you is supposed to kill you. If it doesn't work, someone's really damaged to you. That's a very negative thing.
Do you have a speech order?
All right, what are you going to do?
I was going to discuss our case, and then as I have time, I will discuss your case.
So, off case and on case. In any hour. How many off case?
We just have a counter plan in 1D8.
You don't have to tell me that in future.
Okay.
That would just be two off case.
Oh. So first I'll address our own case and then offer a counterplan, and then I'd like to address my opponent's case. Alright, so we have one disadvantage, and the disadvantage is the balance, is that this plan disrupts the balance between state and federal power. And the uniqueness of this is right now, federal power trades off with state power. So what this means is, like, the more power that the federal government has, states lose more power as well, because basically, like, two entities can't hold the same powers at the same time. So the more the federal government, like, encroaches upon the rights of the states, the more rights that the states lose. So if the federal government, which is, like, the actor in this resolution, begins to dictate, like, the death penalties in various states, then they themselves lose this power. So the importance of this right now, the other uniqueness point, is that the balance between the state and federal government is the key to democracy. This is what is outlined in our, like, 10th Amendment. Because the whole construction of the United States government is based upon the fact that local and state and federal governments have a balance of power that prevents one from infringing on the rights of the other. So, like, this is, like, the system of, like, balances that keep the democracy alive and functioning. And the other uniqueness point is that an example of this would be currently, like, Trump has been trying to get California's undocumented immigrants deported. And he's been infringing on the rights of sanctuary cities to decide the future of their undocumented workers. And this is an example of federal overreach, because the federal government does not have this sort of power. And if his plan is carried out, this will result in great harms to those people. So this is an example of how the federal government tries to encroach on state power, resulting in harms. So initially, and a final uniqueness point, is that state governments are more responsive to their local constituency, and they're better able to represent the local people's interests because they're more in tune with what those people in that specific area want from their power. So the link is that their plan would pass, and this would enable the federal overreach of their power, and the internal link is this strengthens the power of the federal government. So let me outline the harms and the impacts that would occur if this plan would pass. First, we'd see a decrease in democracy, because this would continue the trend of the federal government overreaching its power, which would ultimately result in an erosion of democracy, because democracy can't exist, like, under absolute power, because that will eventually become corrupted and infringe on the rights of states and the peoples within them. Second, this will result in an increase in racism, because right now the current federal government is extremely hostile to several minority groups' interests. So the more that the federal government's power is enabled, the more they'll be infringing upon the rights of minorities and undocumented immigrants. So that those are two impacts from our disadvantage. So moving on to our counterplan. Our counterplan is that the state of Arkansas will abolish the death penalty and replace it with life without parole. So the mutual exclusivity of this is because if Arkansas abolishes the death penalty, then the federal government can't abolish the death penalty, because those two things cannot, like, logically exist at the same time. And the solvency of this is that this avoids the disadvantage, because with the state carrying out this order instead of the federal government, then we won't see this overreach of power resulting in the harms, because it'll be the state that is being the actor, which will uphold states and local rights and the peoples within them. And the solvency is that this solves the case that they outline, and we capture their advantage without falling harm to the disadvantage. So moving on to their plan, since they didn't really define these things, we say that the criterion is net benefits, so whichever one offers up the most net benefits, and it's a policy realm.
So your counterplan is to abolish the death penalty and replace it with life on parole for the immigrants?
No, the counterplan is that the state of Arkansas abolishes the death penalty and replaces it with life without parole.
Okay, so it's so it's the same thing as what you
mean? No, it's not, because the actor. Okay, another point I'd like to address is I believe the affirmative misinterpreted the resolution, because the resolution that we heard was that the United States federal government stays all executions in Arkansas, and to stay an execution is then generally defined as to, like, delay it, not to, so, like, they said that they would abolish the death penalty, but they're not correctly interpreting, like, the resolution, so they can't argue for abolishing the death penalty. They can only argue for the federal government delaying it in Arkansas. Other than that, their advantage, we captured their advantage because we're abolishing the death penalty permanently and we solve for better, but we're also avoiding the disadvantage of the state, the federal government overreaching its power. So for all these reasons, we believe you should vote for the adjudication.
see, there's no prep time in between. You can give me your speech order, please.
So we have to do the disadvantages first, there are advantages, and then we'll discuss about how the fight is just. So let's begin with they mentioned that our positions have disrupted the balance between the state and the federal government, and states are going to lose rights if the federal government actually overreaches and makes it possible for the U.S. to be to have a death penalty abolished altogether. Well, and they also claim that the impact of this will be that democracy will decrease. Well, first of all, the entire U.S. system was built. There's states and federal. There's states government and there's a federal government because it's the power sharing between the federal and the state is actually a core value of the United States. I mean, if the states exist because there's issues that the U.S. Federal government cannot solve altogether. And the federal government, however, is also there to actually impose laws or provide those laws to citizens that sometimes states do not provide to their local citizens. For example, when you talk about abortion rights, which are it's a very controversial issue across the United States. If the federal government doesn't do anything about it, perhaps we would not have different states with different laws when it comes down to different issues, which is obviously, yes, it's not right. And this is related to abortion because they all obviously dehumanizes people, just like the death penalty does. Or the legal injections that are used by the state government that the governor is actually pushing through to have to use them. Also, they mentioned that the key to democracy.
I have a question.
Yes.
Are you advocating that abortion is a good thing or not?
It's abortion is a right.
So it is a right.
It's a right.
Okay. That's it. Thank you.
Also, the option is that one of the impacts is that racism is going to increase because the federal government is racist. Well, okay, isn't state law also state law also can be racist. It's not just something that the federal law gets to do or is. In fact, there's several examples as to how the state law can be racist and discriminatory towards people when it comes down to gay marriage. Abortion rights, all different states are different when it comes down to these rights and how they provide to their people. So the whole impact of how racism is going to increase because federal government is racist, that doesn't make sense because laws are implemented by both federal government and by the state government altogether. And it's a very, it's a slippery slope. Usually the cases of the federal government inputs puts laws in place that are actually more beneficial to the country altogether than state laws. States can be conservative or can be liberal. And the government, when it came down to, for example, gay marriage rights, gay marriage was legalized in several states first, but not all states approved that gay marriage was actually legal. If the federal government hadn't intervened in pushing for gay marriage legalization, perhaps we would have had a state of the country where still gay rights would have been a major issue. Also, So the impact that it's going to increase racism because the federal government is racist doesn't make sense, or I would like to have more clarification on that when the next speaker goes. And yeah, it basically delegitimizes the entire argument that they have. So the counter plan is going to be, also their counter plan is exactly the same as ours. They want to abolish the death penalty. They want to replace it with parole, which actually that's something that we were also pushing for. We're not actually, we're not pushing about that, but we're actually pushing for the having inmates be released altogether in general public, which doesn't make sense because when you look at economic reasons, you look at it through just at the, you know, at the human level, it just makes sense that people should not be put through executions that are costing their lives or they're extremely painful because of the person. Yes.
Are you arguing that all inmates should be released to the general public?
No. All inmates that are in the execution and death row at the moment.
General population. General population.
Okay.
Yes. Yes. Not the public. Just the general.
General population. Yes.
Thank you very much.
And so that's why we just I think that their plan doesn't really solve the issue. And I think ours is probably, it's just better because, once again, death row inmates, once they're sent back to the general population of prisoners, it's just an economic benefit where the government is not using injections, importing it from Europe altogether when U.S. Companies are actually in trouble exporting it with European companies, where there's this rights infringement or there's rights that European companies do not agree with, and they're forced to because obviously it's a market and a capitalistic society, and that's not how we work. So that kind of is going to be put down. The fact that, you know, the controversy between the US companies and the European companies will decrease as a result of no more executions put in place. If no more executions are put in place, then the whole issue between U.S. companies and European companies also going to be solved forever. There's not going to be, that issue is not going to be existing. And so that's why we think we have a better argument and our plan is probably going to solve the issue in a better way.
So I'm just going to respond to their I guess I don't know what the technical term is, but their response is to our disadvantage.
That's just you're going on optics.
Okay. That's what I'm doing.
Yeah. So basically, debate is split into on case and off case. The affirmative, like the advantages or whatever else you might run, the disadvantages, counter plans, any procedurals you run.
Okay.
And then the back and forth, you don't have to go, oh, I'm responding to this response, to this response, to this thing from the beginning. You just say, oh, well, the original thing that we're arguing about is disadvantage one, so therefore it's off case.
Okay.
So.
Thank you for that.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So then I'm going, is that my time? You start starting?
No, you don't have to start.
Okay.
Start when you start talking.
Okay, cool. I'm also going to get up on the podium because the air conditioner comes on and off.
Yeah, it's really loud.
Yeah.
So you said off case that off, right?
Yes.
In the same order? Does it add counter plan?
Yes.
Okay.
And how much time do I have?
8 minutes.
8 minutes, thank you. So you guys mentioned that the United States system was built with state and federal government regulation. And I agree with you, and I think that the plan of having the United States federal government staying the executions in Arkansas would be an overreach of that very fundamental value that the United States is based on. You said that abortion, you mentioned abortion laws will be better executed if the federal government has more power. But currently Donald Trump and Mike Pence do not, they want to take away the women's ability to have abortions. So if the federal government had more power, that would in fact reduce women's ability to get abortions. So I think that actually is a benefit toward us, the fact that the states should have more power, because if the states have more power, then more women will be able to get abortions, which we both agree are necessary and a right thing for the laws in this country. And you said state laws can be racist, but so can federal laws. And one of the most, in my opinion, racist politicians out there today is the President of the United States and the Vice President of the United States. And so we think that giving unnecessary powers to the federal government would negatively impact minorities, especially in places like California. If there becomes normalized that the federal government has more power than the state does, then in California, minorities could be inadvertently targeted and deported and basically just picked on by our government. And then you mentioned the slippery slope of having greater state power. That's like actually a fallacy. That's a well-known fallacy. It's called the slippery slope fallacy. And the idea that just because the state had more power, that the states were going to run away with power and I don't know, start passing negative laws, is not realistic. There's still checks and balances at the state level, and inevitably the general population needs to vote to approve laws. And in some ways, the local population deserve to have their, to some extent, they deserve to have their rights or their opinions executed in their local governments. You said gay marriage would probably not be approved, would not be approved if it wasn't for the federal government. But in fact, states had to go against the federal law to approve gay marriage initially. So the federal government was the major barrier to having legalization of gay marriage. I don't see how the federal government having more power is in any way a good thing, because I believe all people should have the right to marriage if that's what they want. You said the counterclaim was exactly the same, but the counterclaim is not exactly the same. Your counterclaim argues that the federal government should stay the lethal injections in Arkansas, but we argue that Arkansas should eliminate the death penalty altogether. For the reasons that me and my partner have talked about, I believe our plan is much stronger, because overbearing federal government is a very negative thing. And you said we don't solve, but in fact we solve for all the same things, and we don't introduce the negative impact of having an overbearing federal government. We don't believe that there should be lethal injections, so your speech about the negative effects of importing lethal injections and the negative effects of lethal injections on inmates are, we agree with that. We're not saying that's not true. So, for these reasons, we believe you should vote in the negative.
are you structuring this?
Oh, I was just gonna discuss, well, I don't know like the technical term, but just like do like an impact analysis.
Okay, maybe she is what you're saying.
Mm-hmm. All right, so for the final speech from the opposition, I'm gonna discuss just the differences between the respective plan and counterplan and the various impacts that they offer up, and explain why under the criterion of net benefits, our plan offers the most benefits with the least amount of detriments. So their plan, the plan outlined in the resolution that they should be upholding, is that the United States federal government stays all executions in Arkansas. So what they're defending is the federal government passing the law or some sort of order that would prevent these executions being carried out in mass in Arkansas currently going on. And a stay generally refers to like a delay of an order or like delaying these executions. So in their plan, they defined it as banning all executions in Arkansas, and they haven't really discussed the United States federal government as an actor. But let me go over all the reasons that we have discussed for why the United States federal government overreaching its power in such a way would be a negative detriment. So my partner provided and like refuted several examples that the affirmation has brought up of how state power is bad, because in all the specific examples he's discussed, he's shown that generally speaking, states having the power to decide these sorts of laws is an overall benefit for like the nation and for the people within that state. Three main reasons, I suppose, are the first, state governments are more like responsive to their local constituency. The people in those states generally should have a right to decide what laws they want for their people, and that's upheld in our constitution. And second, the balance between the state and federal government is the key to democracy. So our opponents themselves even agreed that this this power structure and balance between the state and federal government is key to our democracy, and they agreed that it was important. So as far as I can tell, I don't really see where the clash is between the fact that this is important. They tried to provide some examples of how laws can be racist and detrimental, but when we're discussing the status quo, like what we have right now, the current government and office at the federal level is hostile to like minority and like undocumented worker interests, as we have like already outlined and discussed. So like examples from the past aren't really relevant, because right now we're looking at a world where that is what is currently going on. So checking federal power right now is what is important, because that's what's going to protect these people and protect their rights. So the impact of this would be we preserve democracy, that we prevent this increase in racism, and we prevent this increase in federal power that preserves our democracy and like protects these people's rights. So discussing their, well, like we said, we capture their advantage and we avoid the disadvantage. So this is the main reason why I believe you should vote for the negation, because right, our plan is superior because the state of Arkansas is the act. If the state of Arkansas is the actor, we'll avoid the our disadvantage, because the federal government does not get to increase its power and does not get to override states' rights in this like aggressive manner. And we'll be capturing their advantages, their like economic advantages that they have discussed, the drugs being expensive, the drugs not working effectively, the effect of the death penalty disproportionately targeting minorities. We capture all of these advantages. And our opponents themselves have admitted that upholding states' rights and the balance between state and federal power is important. So I believe that overall, when you're weighing the round, our counterplan is effective in avoiding the disadvantage and effective in capturing their advantage. So I believe you should vote for the negation. Thanks.
Make this very easy for you. We're talking about executions. We're talking about people getting dehumanized, and we're affirmative team. We're talking about stopping that dehumanization. It's very simple. Our plan is simply we went over our plan text already. We said, look, these executions are dehumanizing these people, and these people are being targeted by the system, and these people. When I say these people, again, going back to my plan text, I'm talking about Latinos and African Americans. They're being targeted And these are the people that they're being dehumanized by getting executed in the system. Their counterplan is really similar to our plan. So I'm just gonna say perm. Let's just do both. It's totally possible. We can do both. Our plan actually reaches the resolution. Our plan is to solves for the resolution, and it takes away almost all the disadvantages. For example, let me just go over a couple of the disadvantages for you, Judge. They talked about that. They were talking about. We were talking about abortion laws in a different context. We're comparing it to how it separates from federal and state laws. Our opponent was starting to talk about abortion laws. They're better than execute. He started comparing abortion laws to what's happened in the past and to Trump and everything. In my view, Judge, that's an appeal to authority policy. When he was talking about the past, it's not relevant to what's happening with our resolution. So, and then going back on down to the plan that we had. Our plan is better than the status quo, definitely. That right now, people are, like I said, some people don't actually die when we get injected, and that's really bad because it's bad that they're dying, but it's really bad if you're trying to kill somebody and you don't kill them, because they're coming out with all types of problems with their health, and it makes it much more harder for them to live as humans. Again, they never saw the negation never solved for us for U.S. companies versus European country regulations. We get our lethal injections from Europe and from European countries, and there's. Our opponent never touched on the fact that we solved for the controversy between the regulating between the U.S. companies and European countries. Okay. And going back on to. So the population in states are distributed. Yeah, and so what I'm getting to, Judge, is our plan is really good. Their counterplan is good. We're saying our plan is better because it reaches more people on a broader scale. Also, what it does is the bottom line is dehumanization. We're stopping dehumanization. We don't want to inject lethal chemicals into people anymore. We want these people to live in the general population in prison instead of being killed in prison. They can live the rest of their life in prison, that's fine. We just don't want to dehumanize them by injecting poison into them, that's all. And for that reason, Judge, that's